So the existing technologies use very expensive input materials and operate slowly. So that's that means that your price per printed part is extraordinarily high.
Right now it's about $100,000 a kilowatt. It's quite slow with just 1 kilowatt laser. So you need 2, and then you need 3. To keep going faster, you have to keep stepping it up.
Our metal printing system works by taking in commodity-priced aluminum wires.
So we feed this solid wire into our ceramic nozzle. So we heat up our nozzle, so the melting point of aluminum, well, actually a little beyond. We heat to 750 degrees Celsius, which is about 1400 degrees Fahrenheit. Solid wire goes in, melts into this nozzle. Then we have an electromagnetic coil that sits outside the ceramic nozzle, and we energize this coil. When we energize this coil, we create a magnetic field which pushes inward on the metal, and that produces a droplet. Every time we produce a magnetic field, it squeezes a droplet out. And so we do that about 1,000 times a second.
Similar to the way an inkjet printer prints with droplets of ink to make your image, we print with very fine droplets of metal.
One of my tenets that my father taught me in engineering is use off-the-shelf parts as much as possible. So if you don't reinvent the wheel, right?
University of Buffalo has been a great help in, from very early on when we were in the basement trying to understand the parameters of the physics.
Pretty much our whole staff is from UB School of Engineering. Our only interaction with our competitors so it was at the IMTS show. So
we were swamped. I mean, we had 6 people going all week long and met over 2,000 people. It's an idea that's time has come, I think. It was very exciting.